Welcome. Thank you for coming to listen to the Lichen Sclerosis Podcast. My name is Kathy, and this is our journal of learning about and living with lichen sclerosis. Each week, I research or talk to somebody about an aspect of lichen sclerosis and bring you the information. If you've been a regular listener, then you know mental health is a huge part of why I'm passionate about bringing you resources and information about lichen sclerosis. It's that silent symptom that sneaks up on you and can destroy everything around you before you even notice it's there. So by highlighting it, I hope I can bring awareness so you can notice it before it gets out of control. I don't only want to bring awareness to it, I also want to try to get you some skills and help on how to relieve these symptoms. In that vein, I'm going to start bringing experts that will share different modalities on how to change your mindset, how to get over negative feelings and thoughts, and how to help us deal with the stress and the emotional side of lichen sclerosis. My guest today is the first of these mindset experts. She's a scientist, she's an engineer, a PhD. We're going to discuss her new book, Pull Back Your Power, and her journey on struggling through mental health to creating this process to help other women get back their power, their self-esteem, and find the resilience that they need to live in this crazy world. Her name is Dr. Ann Whitehouse. She's a women's coach and a subconsciousness healing specialist. She's going to share with us her step-by-step process on how to refocus our subconsciousness and share a way we can get even deeper healing. Without further ado, here is my conversation with Dr. Ann Whitehouse. Ann, thank you so much for coming to teach us your process, to show us that we can get our self-esteem back. LS has my self-esteem personally in the toilet, and that's something that I'm working on. So I'm super excited about you talking to us.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
So I know this was a very personal journey for you to develop this process. Can you tell us what happened and how it came about?
I started out as a scientist, a high-achieving academic, and I went into my career with my science PhD. Well, I went in really wanting to be a role model to other women. I went into an engineering department, and I was what we call in the UK a university lecturer. I think you'd call that a college professor. And What I found was that in that environment, I just reacted with the most enormous stress and anxiety you could possibly imagine. It was completely out of proportion with what was actually going on the surface. And this is something that many women experience, I've since discovered. And what actually happened was that I sort of spiraled into this complete meltdown of stress, anxiety, insomnia, and it became what I call a spectacular burnout. And after 6 years, I'd lost my career and I'd lost my health as well. And for me, I'd managed to create chronic fatigue syndrome. Well, the thing that struck me right from the start, it was that I was reacting out of proportion with my environment. And I was taking everything inside and it was coming into a huge ball of negativity, which was all about, I'm not good enough, right? It was about, I'm not good enough. I don't belong here. I shouldn't be here. And I think most women can probably relate to this in some guise or other, right? And so but when you're in that spiral, everything you do doesn't feel good enough, right? So then you take it in further and then you push yourself harder and you criticize yourself more and you get more into that complete self-judgment thing. And then, of course, you just spiral and spiral and spiral in the wrong direction. Now, in my case, what I discovered is that we are receiving a whole load of subconscious messages as women, because we are being judged by a whole load of benchmarks when we're out in the world. Mm-hmm. So what I really struggled with and what caused me to react in this way, it was because I was very much out there in this male-dominated environment. And I've now discovered that our subconscious is completely still rooted in the past. And we are literally having our subconscious minds whispering to us about all of these limitations and things that are forbidden for women to do, the way we have to behave, you know, the way we shouldn't behave. And this is completely at odds with anybody who is a professional woman trying to succeed out in the world. So we're getting this huge mixed message, which creates enormous amount of inner conflict, because your subconscious mind is saying, this is forbidden. You are going to be punished. You're going to be put to death if you continue to have this high-powered academic career. And in my case, engineering, I was in authority over a lot of men. And that was totally forbidden, right, for a woman.
Right.
So that is how I went into my personal spiral. But of course, you know, what other people have in their lives can come from all kinds of different situations and different experiences. But the key thing that I really want to talk about today is the effect of the subconscious messages and how that then eats away at your self-esteem. When that happens, you get into a negative spiral where it kind of mushrooms into the wrong direction.
Right. Like with us, with LS, that spiral of we stop being able to perform sexually. We stop feeling that intensity for sex that we may have felt before. So we feel less of a woman. We start worrying about how our partners are going to look at us. Mm-hmm. And then that, again, the more spiral, we start worrying and then anxiety. And then we feel like we're not performing in our relationship in general, not even sexually. And then also not even just with sex, because LS tends to take over your life in the beginning until you learn to manage it, because it's all you can think about. You're worrying about how you're going to be in the future, because it is a progressive disease. Mm-hmm. You're worrying about developing cancer. You're worrying about, are you doing the right things? So all of these things, like you said, they spiral us down until we feel like, what's the point? We might as well just not even be in a relationship. Mm-hmm. We're no good to anybody. And our self-esteem is down at the bottom.
Exactly.
How did you come out of it? What did you do?
Well, I had what I call a moment of clarity. And that was when I was absolutely at rock bottom with my chronic fatigue. I was lying on the sofa. I was only 30. And literally, I could not stand up. I could not walk. And I was trying to pick up a pen to write in a birthday card. And I didn't have the strength to move my arm and pick up the pen. That's how bad it was.
Oh, wow.
And I just lay there and I thought, I'm not prepared to accept that this is my life. And you know, the conventional medicine had said, good luck. We can't help you. Good luck and goodbye. That's literally what the consultant told me.
Wow.
So it was that moment, and it was that mental decision that I made to make it different. I thought, I'm going to find a solution because I'm not prepared to accept that this is my life. And it was like a switch. I can remember it so vividly. It was like this switch flicking in my head. And I thought, no, I'm not having that future that I've been told I'm going to have. I'm going to find a way. And that was the start of me investigating. Now, luckily, I mean, I am a scientist. I've got an experimentalist mind. So I would try everything. And very quickly, it went from what my body was doing to what my mind was doing. And I went into understanding how my mind had perceived the world. And I did a lot of training, but it was only when I discovered what was happening sort of on a deep energetic level that things began to get, you know, really exciting. Our subconscious mind, it will look at our situation and it will interpret it in a certain way. And if it believes from its benchmark, its rule book for the world, that you are in danger in some way, it then literally panics and it goes into what I call a submission response. You know, when you've got like two animals fighting and the weaker one submits and it kind of you know, shows its belly or its throat to show I'm the weaker animal. So that's a very, very deep evolutionary response that we all have. As small girls, when we, for example, we might get shouted at, We might get scared by something. And even if we aren't in real danger, this mechanism triggers. And literally what our subconscious says is, I have to give away all my power in order to be safe, either to avoid being destroyed or to be taken care of. This is absolutely programmed in on this deepest level. And but this time I'd wondered, you know, why was it that I changed so much of my beliefs around things? And yet I would still have this response, this kind of magnified anxiety response about certain things in my life. And this was the key. This was the thing. And so I thought, right, now I need to work out how to undo this.
So this is very similar to the internal thought of, okay, we may have painful sex or we may not be able to have sex. Mm-hmm. So the whole thing of society or us being taught that as women, we're supposed to be sexual beings for our partners, our spouses, or whatever. And if we can't fulfill that social role,
yeah,
then we're not worthy of that position.
Right.
Is that kind of what you're saying?
Yes, exactly. So the first step in taking back the control is to separate out the actual facts and your interpretation of the facts. So when there is something, you know, that a woman is dealing with that is very, very big, like LS, or like someone who's been abused or someone who's been raped, what you've got is the facts of it are the facts and you can't change those. Mm-hmm. But in terms of you as a human being, it is a very, very, very small proportion of who you really are, right?
Right.
It's an incredibly small proportion of your value as a human being, as a woman, you know, as a person, what you can offer, you know, to the world, to your partner, to your children, your friends, what you can create, you know, what you can give, you know, your intelligence, your humor, all of those things. And what happens is that the subconscious gets into that, so this spiral. I think about that as like a microscope. So what we do is when this submission response triggers in our subconscious, it's literally going into the like the ultimate fight or flight. And you get the issue that you are really stressed about and you are putting it under the subconscious microscope, and you look in the microscope and it looks really big.
Yeah.
Because it's under the lens, right?
Yeah.
And then you say, oh my goodness,
right.
I've got to magnify this because I've got to see what's in there. So you turn up onto a stronger lens and it gets even bigger and you panic. And by this time, like exactly like you said in the beginning, your entire mind is completely fixated on this one issue. So you are forever turning up the lens magnification to see more and more and more details because your mind thinks, I need to do this to be safe, to work out my problem, to keep myself safe or whatever.
Right. In our case, we're like, okay, we have to fix this. We have to figure out how to fix this so that we don't lose our relationship, so that we are not bad partners, so that we still feel feminine and beautiful and sexy. So we have to get this right. And the more fixated we are on it and the more we can't get it right, then the more we feel like we're failures and it's that spiral.
That's exactly it. You've hit the nail on the head. So while you are there looking at that issue under the microscope and it's completely taken over your whole life, everybody else sees you as a person and sees this tiny, tiny little slide under the microscope and doesn't even hardly notice it.
Right.
So we want to get ourselves out from looking through this microscope, just standing at the side saying, well, that's a really small thing there. And look at the rest of me. I'm amazing. That is easier said than done. And this is the key. It's because once we are locked into that, we just go down and down and down. Mm-hmm. But what you need to then do is to really pull, and this is the title of my book, Pull Back Your Power. You're pulling your focus away from that issue. Mm-hmm. And we actually do it as a pulling process, because you can get so locked into what it is that you're focusing on that it's like a trap. And I know what it's like. I know how locked you can be and how much it will completely take over your existence.
Yeah.
Bottom line is that the world will see this tiny issue on the microscope slide. And that's the truth. That's the truth. The world is going to see you as an amazing woman, as a human being with so much to offer.
You're right. I've had women who've contacted me who said they're neglecting their spouse, they're neglecting their children, their work has suffered because they are so focused on lichen sclerosis. They're so focused on their disease and trying to figure out what they need to do, how to care for themselves, what is their future going to look like. It's just so focused that everything else kind of falls to the wayside. And so hopefully today your process will help start getting us to where we can have less focus on LS and more focus back onto our normal lives and the people that we love around us. So tell us, how are we going to do this?
Right. Okay. So I'm going to take you through it step by step. And this is something which I would recommend that you do a lot initially, because it's like training yourself to do something you've never done before. Yeah. So when I first did this process with me, I went through it and I felt so much better. It was like, oh my God, is this really me? Do I really feel like this? It's amazing. But as soon as I kind of relaxed, I lost it all. Mm-hmm. And it was literally as if I was pouring water into a sieve. I simply couldn't hold that new state because it was so, so new, so alien to my energy system. Mm-hmm. The first few days, I was doing it literally every few minutes. But after, so 3 or 4 days, I was doing it every now and then. And after a couple of weeks, I was actually holding the new energy state pretty well. And something might happen to sort of knock me for a minute. And then I'd realize that I'd lost it again and I'd pull it back in again. So it's a question of training yourself. It's not a quick fix. It's a, right, I need to train my subconscious to react in a different way, that this is safe and that this is, in fact, much, much better.
It's practice makes perfect.
Practice makes perfect. And it doesn't take that long, but you do have to persevere in the first few days. So I really want to emphasize that.
Okay.
The first thing that you do is to close your eyes and allow the issue to come into your mind, whatever angle of it is really causing you anxiety and stress at that moment. And I want you to see that the issue is there external to you. It's not within you, it's external to you. So the fact is really small. The big negative energy is very big, right? It's very large. And you have created that with your subconscious response. Mm-hmm. No judgment about this. This is the normal default that we all do in these kind of situations, totally. But understanding that, that's a case of knowledge as power. When you understand that the big magnified feeling is something that you can reduce and you're going to feel better, it's like, oh, great. I've already got some control back.
Right.
Okay. So what we're doing now is taking our subconscious mind off the issue forcibly and making it go somewhere else. And the best way to do this is to put your hand flat on your chest. So when I do it, I just put my left hand on my chest and my right hand on top, but whatever way is comfy for you.
Mm-hmm.
And apply a little bit of pressure. That's quite important.
Okay.
So you've got your eyes closed, hands on your chest, and you're putting a little bit of pressure. And then you put your focus, your mental focus, on the sensation of that pressure. Okay. Now, you may have met other techniques where you're told to focus on your breathing. Now, this is easier because you're applying the pressure. That's much easier for your mind to get that focus onto.
Okay, so you're redirecting your attention.
Exactly. You're redirecting the attention and you're giving your subconscious mind a task. You're saying, right, hook onto the sensation of this pressure. If you find that it's not easy, press a little bit harder. And just doing that will immediately begin to calm your mind down a little bit. So what I recommend then is to just breathe gently, holding that focus for 1 or 2 minutes. And you're doing that time, if your mind wanders, you just bring that attention back. If your mind wanders, press a little bit harder again and focus on that sensation. So this is the starting point. And that just unlocks it a little bit. Now we're talking about your power. So your power is literally where your focus is. You can think about this like, say, antelope on the plains of Africa. And they are always looking for that predator. They are always thinking they're in danger and they've got to run for their life at any moment.
Right.
So their focus is always away from them. And when we're in this state, that's what we've done. Our focus has gone straight into, I'm in danger, there's a predator. And so that locks us into that submission response and all the anxiety that goes with it.
Mm-hmm.
So at this point, I want you to imagine that there's a wire attached to your chest and it goes from you to the heart of the issue. Again, that might be different on different days. It's what is the most intense acute angle that you're really struggling with at that particular moment. So you just imagine there's a wire attaching you to it. And on that wire, you've got threaded a big ball. And so this ball can slide up and down on the wire. And at the moment, the ball is with the issue. And that means that the issue has all of your power. So what I then ask you to do is to, in your mind's eye, or if you want to, you can actually reach out your hands and do this physically as well. You reach out and you grab the ball and you pull it back. You pull it along the wire and you slide it back towards you. Now, the thing to understand is this is not a kind of click your fingers and it's done. You imagine there is resistance. You've got to really pull and you feel it sliding down the wire. And it's that resistance is because you are locked into that other state. But again, by focusing your mind on that and understanding that, oh, I've got to pull against that resistance and pull it back with some effort, that actually has the effect of undoing this locking mechanism. So you pull this ball back and imagine that you've pulled that ball into your chest now. You've now got your hands on your chest again. You're imagining the ball in your chest and you can imagine it whatever way works for you. Maybe a brightly coloured ball, or maybe it's a ball of light. Maybe it's a ball of fire, but this is your power. So now you focus inside your chest on that ball that is the ball of your power. Imagine the details of it, whether it's sparkly light or whether it's flames or whether it's beautiful swirling colours. As you do that, an amazing thing happens. Your power literally returns. And it's like electricity flowing down a circuit or water flowing down a river or something. It's literally flowing back to you. And the more you focus on that energy inside you, mm-hmm. you're literally taking the energy away from that negative subconscious ball of anxiety and stress that was created. It's literally like you're deflating that energy. So as you do that, what you'll find is that your stress just gently begins to go down. And you know, your anxiety goes down and you become calmer. Now, then your mind is going to stop freaking out. And now is the time when you can talk some sense into it, because you know, you've got your conscious mind has been doing its absolute best to do the right thing.
Right.
And your subconscious has been magnifying and making everything worse. But at this point, this is when you can tell your subconscious mind, say, hey, come on, you know, that issue, it's so tiny. Look at it now. We've pulled all the power out of it. It's this tiny, tiny little thing. It's a fact. We do have to take certain actions. We do have to look after ourselves, et cetera, et cetera. But that is like, you know, 0.01% of who I am as a person,
right,
and who I am as a woman and what I can actually give to the world. And the rest, that is what everybody else sees. So creating that spiral of negative energy, there's no point to that. So you're telling your subconscious, you didn't need to do that. Look at the truth. Look at the truth. You know, this is a tiny thing. When we've pulled the power out of it, all that's left is just a few facts. As you do this more than once, obviously, you will begin to put these new patterns into your mind. And your subconscious will begin to start saying, well, oh, actually, maybe I don't need to react so extremely. Maybe I can, you know, not create this huge fight or flight stress response all the time. And as you do that, it's going to be an effect that's going to magnify in the right direction, because every time you pull yourself out of all that stress and anxiety, your body's going to relax and then your well-being will increase and then your body feels safer. And then your mind is going to say, oh, well, actually, I do feel a bit safer today. Maybe things aren't so bad. And so you've turned the corner on that spiral. And that is the thing that is so absolutely crucial. It's stopping it when you are in a really bad place and knowing how to turn that corner and start coming back up again. And the more you do it, the more you have the positive conscious mindset with that understanding, that's really, really helpful. But when you've pulled the power back and the subconscious mind has switched off its huge panic anxiety mechanism and begins to relax, that's when that inner conflict reduces. And that's when you can begin to really take back the control. So whatever issue is really triggering for you that particular day, what you do is acknowledge it. Then hands on your chest, put the pressure on and just focus on that sensation. Hold that for 1 or 2 minutes until you begin to feel a bit calmer. Then you imagine that wire between your chest and the issue, and the ball is on the wire. And at the moment, you do not have the ball because you do not have your power. Then you reach out, grab the ball. You can do that in your mind's eye, or you can do it reaching out as well with your physical hands. Imagine grabbing that ball and pulling it against that resistance, pulling it along the wire until it's into your chest. Then you focus on that ball in your chest for at least 2 minutes. Okay. And as you do that, that has the effect of switching off that response in your mind and taking all the heat or the negativity out of what you were feeling, because you're taking the power away from the issue and you're returning it to yourself. Mm-hmm. And then you can remind yourself, hey, you know, this is only, I'd say, 0.01% of who I am as a human being. I have all of this other stuff in my life that I can give, and that is what the world sees. So you're retraining your mind to have a different response. And the more you do it, the effect is going to magnify, and you're going to be able to hold that well-being more and more in your everyday life.
So we're refocusing into our whole being, not just our LS, because our LS is just a small part of who we are. We are way bigger than that.
Perfect. You're way bigger than that. And what you don't want to do is to give all your power to the LS.
Correct.
What you want is to recognize that it is a fact, but you don't have to give it your power.
Love that. Love that. So we do this multiple times a day when we're feeling the anxiety and the stress coming in, to refocus from that stressor back to our whole being.
Yes.
Is there anything else that we can do that would take us deeper into a more, maybe a relaxed state, or to get us further out of that stressed state?
Yes, definitely. So what I've just taught you is for you to retrain yourself and reduce, as you say, that in the moment anxiety and get that back into a better state. But there's going to be a whole load of accumulated stress and trauma and self-judgment that we are going to be holding within ourselves, within our minds, our bodies, our energy fields. And you know, anything you can do that is a deep relaxation is going to help that. But I've actually got a recording of a deep self-nurturing meditation. And this has the effect of just really reducing programs of self-judgment and bringing in self-nurturing. And it also takes you into a very deep state, working with your brainwaves. This is a free meditation, and I've provided the link so that anybody listening to this can go to that link and listen to that healing meditation. It just reduces the accumulated stress over time and the trauma, and it will take you into a very deep, relaxed state. So it's very good for your mental well-being, very good for your self-esteem, in particular self-acceptance and self-respect and self-nurturing, all of those beautiful things. And the only thing I will say is don't listen to that while you're driving or doing anything involving your machinery, because it will make you very relaxed and you may even fall asleep.
Oh.
But that is going to help clear all of the stress that you've been holding onto. And you know, the more you hold that in your body, the more your body is going to be under even more pressure, and you know, you've got enough to deal with anyway.
Perfect. I will have a link to that in the show notes. That might be good for us to do like before we go to bed, or when we're getting ready to just chill for the night or for the day.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
I definitely could use that, because I have a hard time going to sleep because my mind is always racing with things that I'm thinking about. What do I need to get done? So that would definitely be helpful for me to go to sleep, to turn those thoughts off and get into that calm state.
Definitely. This is my go-to for anyone who is in a state of long-term stress or anxiety.
Perfect. So tell us about your book.
So my book is Pull Back Your Power. And it has my story of what I went through as an academic, as a scientist, and what I discovered was in the subconscious operating system undermining all women. And I then go into how we can get ourselves out of these traps. Although I am speaking in the book in terms of the messages we get out in the world as career women, everything I say can be applied to any part of your life. So you can use the same techniques and the same understandings to deal with how you're feeling about LS as well. I just want to emphasize that. With the book, there are actually there's an online bonus section with lots of free reprogrammings and other meditations that help you bring the power back into your mind in a bigger way. The hidden messages that we receive, the subconscious operating system, the undercurrent of society still has women held back in so Absolutely. Many ways. Yes. So my book is all about how to free ourselves from all of those things so that we can, you know, be ourselves, we can do what we want, we can behave as we want, we can shine as brightly as we want, and literally, you know, live our lives to the full as we are meant to. And
that.
When that is squashed by anything, you know, squashed by the male patriarchy in an engineering department, or squashed because of the expectations that are on us in our family, or because of the expectations on us around our bodies, the same thing happens. We crush ourselves to try and fit into this box, and that goes straight to our self-worth, our self-esteem, and our physical well-being, yes. and of course our mental health as well. So by unlocking all of these subconscious restraints, we finally become free to be ourselves and to love ourselves and to accept ourselves without being undermined, so we can achieve and live without the personal cost.
Absolutely. And where can we get the book?
The book is available on Amazon. And I've also got the audiobook, which is on Audible and iTunes.
I will have a link to all of those places where you can get her book. And Anne has been gracious enough to offer 2 signed copies. Stay tuned to the end to find out how to get your own signed copy of Pull Back Your Power. And if my listener wants to get in touch with you and learn more, where can we go?
If you want to reach me, my website is feminineconfidence.com. I have an online empowerment group, which is called the Power Sanctuary. And there I am doing live calls once a month. There's recorded healings, meditations and clearings that are in our membership site. And the whole point of this is to have empowerment in all respects. So we work on love, relationships, money, well-being, career, leadership, our higher purpose, all of those things. If you want to clear the subconscious, you know, conditioning that's been blocking you, holding you back, then it's the perfect place. And I also do have one-to-one coaching and mentoring and all that kind of thing as well. So if you just go to my website, feminineconfidence.com, you can connect with me there, and I look forward to seeing you.
Thank you so much, Anne. I've learned so much, and I'll definitely be trying these techniques, because I have got to get my sexy back and stop focusing on on LS as much. So, and I know my listener feels the same, because LS affects us mentally as much as it does physically. And there's no medication to get our brain off of these nasty thoughts. So you've given us a tool, and I look forward to using it. I look forward to hearing how my listener has used it and their results. And I really appreciate you coming and sharing that with us today.
You're so welcome. It's been a pleasure being here.
Wow. I don't know about you, but I know I'm ready to pull back my power and try to get my sexy back. Let me know if you're going to try Dr. Anne's method and how it works. If you want to learn more about Dr. Anne or would like to work with her, I will have all of her links to all of her social media and her website in the show notes. Let her know you heard about her on the podcast. I'm sure she would love to know that. I would also have a link to her deep meditation. I'd love to hear how that works for you as well. And if you want a chance of getting your own personalized signed copy of Dr. Anne's book, Pull Back Your Power, all you need to do is leave a review for the podcast wherever you listen and email me a screenshot at Kathy with a K at lichensclerosispodcast.com. And for the next 2 weeks, I will take all of the names of everybody who emails me and have an auto picker pick two of the names. And two lucky winners will win a personalized signed copy of Dr. Anne's book, Pull Back Your Power. Like I said, Dr. Anne is just the first. We're going to have many experts sharing their methods of how to change our mindsets, because it's not a one-size-fits-all. I truly believe that mind work is just as individualized as lichen sclerosis is. What works for me may not work for you. So I will be bringing a variety of voices with a variety of methods to find what works for you. Let me know what helps so I can get more voices like that for you. Don't forget, I'm going to be starting my live Q&A soon. So if you have any questions about lichen sclerosis that you would like answered, please email them to me at Kathy@lichensclerosispodcast.com along with the screenshot of your reviews. And I look forward to talking to you next week. I hope you have an amazing week, and I will talk to you then.